Ladies and gentlemen, will you please be upstanding for the arrival of the bridal party? Which is being duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. We are here today to witness and to celebrate the marriage of Stuart and Amy. And on their behalf, may I thank you for joining with them in this, the celebration of their very special day. We do hope it will be a happy, memorable day for you all. And I usually say it, but especially for you two, but I think it's going to be especially for you five. And as we begin the ceremony, I have a question for another very special gentleman. It's not Daddy this time, not yet. May I ask who presents Amy to be married to Stuart? Thank you, sir. Now, would you like to give your daughter a and to shake the hand of your future son-in-law? Thank you very much. Now, sir, would you like to take your seat? And Amelia, is there a chair for you, do you think? Is there? Excellent. And Gracie, is there a chair for Gracie? Sit where that one. Okay, you sit with that one. Wonderful. And don't worry, if they want to come and join in at some point later on, that's fine. My name is Anne, and on behalf of Northamptonshire County Council Registration Service, it's my very special and very pleasant duty to conduct your ceremony today. My colleague is Jane, and as the registrar, it's her responsibility to witness your marriage and to issue the certificate. Now, Amy, would you like to put those beautiful flowers on the table? That's fine. Good. You are without a helper. Does that help?
It does.
Good. Ladies and gentlemen, Stuart and Amy have found in each other happiness fulfillment and love. Their relationship has been deepened and enriched by Amelia, Gracie and Joseph, whom we all welcome here today. Stuart and Amy now wish to affirm their relationship, to offer to each other and their children the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. But before we can proceed with the wedding ceremony, I do have to ask that if any person here present knows of any lawful impediment why Stuart and Amy may not be joined in matrimony, they should declare it now.
It's good.
It's very good. We'll carry on. So, Stuart, please state your full name.
It's Stuart Martin Ashfield.
Thank you. And Amy, please state your full name.
Amy Louise Mulberry.
Stuart Martin Ashfield. Amy Louise Smalley. Before you are joined in matrimony, it's my duty to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life, the exclusion of all others. But further, it's a special union to provide love, care, support, and friendship to each other throughout the joys and sometimes the challenges that we know life can bring. And so I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that to the best of your knowledge and belief, there is no lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. So, Stuart, will you please repeat after me? I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Stuart Martin Ashfield.
Why that I, Stuart Martin Ashfield.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Amy Louise Smalley.
To Amy Louise Smalley.
Amy, please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
No lawful impediments.
Why? Why I, Amy Louise Smalley. Why I,
Amy Louise Smalley.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Stuart Martin Ashby.
To Stuart Martin Ashby.
We did it. The moment has now arrived, ladies and gentlemen, for Stuart and Amy to contract their marriage before you, their witnesses, their friends, and their families. These special words will join them together, both formally and publicly. And although they've invited you all here to witness their marriage today, there are two specially designated witnesses I'm going to call forward. Stephen, please step forward, and Ben, please step forward. Stephen, Ben, have I got it the right way around?
Yes.
I think you two are very lucky to have two such fine, outstanding witnesses with such special gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, can I ask that if it is comfortable for you to do so, please stand and join together for the celebration of the marriage. And I'm going to ask you two to face each other and to hold hands. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand if you think it's comfortable for you. And Stephen and Ben, your job here is to listen to the words that are going to be spoken now, because in a few minutes' time we will ask you to sign the register to say that yes, you're perfect. I'm going to start, Stuart, by asking you a question. Stuart, will you take Amy be your wedded wife, to share your life with her, to love, support and comfort her, whatever the future may bring?
I do.
Please repeat after me. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Stuart Martin Ashfield.
To witness that I, Stuart Martin Ashfield.
Do take thee, Amy Louise Smalley.
Do take thee, Amy Louise Smalley.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And Amy, same question for you. Amy, will you take Stuart to be your wedded husband? Tish. You've got to have a whole question. We like it when it gets started. Let's wait for the question. Will you take Stuart to be your wedded husband? To share your life with him? To love, support and comfort him? Whatever the future may bring.
I do.
Please repeat after me. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Amy Louise Smalley.
To witness I, Amy Louise Smalley.
Do take thee, Stuart Martin Ashfield.
Take thee, Stuart Martin Ashfield.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Perfect. Gentlemen, did you hear those words?
Yes. Yes.
Good. Please be seated, everybody. But there's a very special young lady who's going to say a few special words. This is your turn now, Amelia. Want to come and stand at the front?
You'll be okay.
She'll be fine. There are people to help if you get mumbled, okay?
Mum and Dad get married today. I'd like to help them on their way. So here's some advice from me to help them with our family. Keep our house filled with laughter. Let's have fun forever after. Keep the drawer filled up with sweets. And give us children lots of treats. Make sure you spend time together to keep your happiness forever. Make sure you spend lots on us and then the kids won't make a fuss. But the most important thing here is to show your love in all you do. A caring word, a kiss, a touch, and those family cuddles that mean so much.
That was brilliant, Amelia. Well done. That needs another hand here. So, ladies and gentlemen, traditionally, a wedding ceremony is marked by the exchange of rings. These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love and are an outward sign of the lifelong promises that you are making to each other. May these rings remind you always of the vows that you pledged to each other today. Now, the question is, who has got the rings? Is this going to be a joint effort? Do you want to come and help?
You don't have to if you don't want to. It's you. You want to stand there? Stand
next to Mum.
That's it. Would you like to give the box to Uncle Stephen? Perfect. Well done. And he'll open it for you. And then we're going to ask Daddy a question. Now, say to Daddy, which ring is going to be for Mummy? Stuart, you have to choose the one that is going to fit on Amy's finger. Beep, beep.
Wait a minute.
Okay, you know what you're doing now.
Yeah.
Fine. Take Amy's left hand in your hand. If you're not sure which finger is going to be,
I know which one it is.
Put the ring on the tip of her finger. Hold it there. And repeat these words after me. Amy, I give you this ring.
Amy, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a token of our love.
And as a token of our love.
And push the ring onto her finger. Slide it on gently. Keep hold of her hand and read her those words.
I promise to care for you, to trust and confide in you, and to be faithful to you always. I give you my love and friendship, my comfort and support. I promise to respect and cherish you for all that life may bring. These promises I make to you sincerely for the rest of my life.
There should be another ring still in the box.
There's one.
Please take that. Please take Stuart's hand in your hand, put the ring on the tip of his finger, hold it there, and repeat these words up to me. Stuart, I give you this ring.
Stuart, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And as a token of our love.
As a token of our love.
And slide the ring onto his finger. Keep hold of his hand and read the words.
I promise to give you my love and friendship, to support and comfort you through good times and through troubled times. I promise to care for you with love and with patience, to respect and cherish you and be faithful always. These promises I make to you sincerely and for the rest of my life.
Families of Stuart and Amy, through the vows that they have made today, they are pledging themselves to each other for the years ahead, believing that whatever life may hold for them, they will share with the strength and the love that their marriage will bring. Today is a new beginning for you both. This day will form a milestone in your lives, and I do hope that you will look back on it with much joy and happiness. Stuart Martin Ashfield, Amy Louise Smalley, you have now made your declarations of marriage as prescribed by law, and through them have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of the registrar, your witnesses, your families here assembled. And it gives me great pleasure to pronounce that you are now joined together lawfully as husband and wife. Really did take place. So just in case you wake up tomorrow morning and think, what was it we did yesterday? All you'll have to do is to make sure you check the certificate, and there it is. And ladies and gentlemen, in accordance with tradition, I'm going to present this to, not you, Stuart, but the person who's probably going to be making a lot of important decisions, the bride. So. But I'm having passed you the envelope, I'm going to suggest to you that you haven't actually got any wood pockets in that lovely dress. No. But I do need you both to come and stand in front of the table. And if you would join me, will you register? You're going to have your hands full with your flowers, and very special good luck charm. Now, young man, you're on the wrong side there. We like a bit of tradition, but you don't have to climb over the dress. You can never. You see, traditionally, the bride enters the room on her father's right arm. But she leaves the room on the left arm of her new husband. And there's a reason for this, and I bet even Amelia doesn't know the reason for this, but it's so that when the couple leave the room, it leaves the sword arm of the new husband free to protect his beautiful wife just in case. So, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the last time and give a rousing welcome to the newly married Mr. and Mrs. Ashfield.
My new wife, which is a weird to say, but finally,
I'd just like to thank you all for coming to share our special day with us today. Obviously, apparently there's some kind of global pandemic going on. That's prevented, obviously, other family and friends being here with us to celebrate this day. As Amy would say, my new wife, it's like hashtag do on COVID. It's one of the things that come out from it. Amy, we're calling you Amy as well, it's not normal.
What do you call her?
I cannot believe, obviously, how lucky I am to have met you. Who would have thought that from the day we met, we ended up here for our first kiss. And I thought I'd ask you out. More worried about getting you home late than what Phil was going to say. Obviously, you're not only just my best friend, you're the love of my life. You look absolutely beautiful today. I'm so lucky to be able to call you my wife. I love you for the woman and the mother you are and the person that you have made me. I want to thank you for the blessings beyond my imagination. Three of them are obviously sat down over there, and the four is obviously sat right next to me. Every moment we spend together is a special one, and I'm looking forward to the special moments we spend together in the future. I'm incredibly proud of you for what you do, and I'm so happy to finally get to call you my wife. I'd like to thank my mum and dad for the support you've given not just me, but me and Amy as a couple. Some things would never have been possible without your support. Phil, Lisa, you've raised the most beautiful, respectful, appreciative daughter. And mother, and as proud as I am of her, as to be my wife, I hope you're proud of her, your daughter, that she's come to you. Finally, can I just ask that you all stand and raise a toast to my beautiful wife and to the family who are not here to share this special moment with us. To my wife.
Thank you.